We'll continue with sound chapter. We already studied V is equal to lambda F. F is equal to 1 by time period. Okay. Now, what is the requisite for a medium? Requisite means what are the requirements or mandatory things for any medium in order to produce sound? First, it should be elastic. Why elastic? Because if it is elastic, then only we can produce sound. It should be elastic so that it comes back to its original position. Second, it should be having inertia. Inertia, the meaning of inertia, it should have mass. Inertia means it should have mass. It should be elastic and it should be free from any friction, means it should be frictionless. Medium should be elastic. It should have inertia. Inertia means what? Mass. Mass means it should have some material. Then only it will vibrate. And it should be frictionless, because if there is friction, there will be loss in the energy. So these are the requisite. Requisite means what? The requirement, the important things needed for an object. So it's requisite, elastic, inertia, and it should be frictionless energy. Next. What are the factors on which speed of sound depend? Factors on which speed of sound depend. Could be in any medium. Okay, this is in general. So, you can just remember the formula. It is directly proportional to E is elasticity. Just now I mentioned elasticity and density. It depends on both. Okay. It depends on elasticity and density. You have no numerical based on this formula. But just remember, depends on elasticity. How elastic is the object? If it is elastic, then the speed will be more. And it also depends on density. Both the factors it depends, not just one factor. Factors on which speed of sound depend. It could be in any medium, solid, liquid or gas. Any medium depends on the elasticity of the medium and second, the density. Now, factors on which speed of sound in gas depends. Very important, I am specifying in gas. Gas means air. I have made a short form, DTDH. There is a courier company DTDC. Instead of DTDC, we will say DTDH. First is direction of wind. Second, temperature. Third, density. And fourth, humidity. Direction of wind. If it is in the direction of the wind. So if you are standing here and the wind is coming from this direction, sound is also coming from this direction. So definitely the speed will be more. In the direction, the speed will be more. Temperature. If temperature is more, speed of sound is also more. Example, mom is cooking food. So she has made pav bhaji. The fragrance of pav bhaji will come in your hall also, living area also. Because as temperature increases, the kinetic energy of the particles also increase. Hence, it travels faster. So remember, temperature more, kinetic energy is also more. So speed will be more. Density of the substance. Density. Density is more. The speed of sound will also
be decrease.
Humidity. Humidity is more. If humidity is more, then the speed will also be, so it depends on four factors, D, T, D, H, D, T, D, H, direction of wind, temperature, density, humidity. Humidity means what? Humidity is the presence of moisture. Okay. Next, factors on which it does not depends. The short form is PAU. Factors on which it does not depend. The short form is PAU. PAU is what? Pressure, amplitude, and wavelength. We can also say frequency instead of wavelength. So it does not depend on PAU. PAU means what? Pressure, amplitude, and wavelength. It does not depend on PAW. Pressure, amplitude, and wavelength. Just to confuse you, they will say speed of sound was 340 meter per second. When pressure was doubled, what will be the speed? You will say it does not depend on pressure. Does not depend on amplitude. What is the meaning of amplitude? It is the maximum displacement of the particle from its mean position. Does not depend. Means the loudness. So speed does not depend on loudness. And the third one is the wavelength. It does not depend on the wavelength. If wavelength is more, less, frequency more, less, it does not depend on that. Okay. Depend on DTDH. Does not depend on PAU. Very important. And again, this I'm talking about gas. I'm talking about gas. Speed of sound is actually 330 meter per second, but sometimes we also take it as 340. I'm talking about air. Why 330, 340? Because it depends on temperature. Just now I said, depends on the temperature. So 330 is at 0 degrees Celsius. 340 is approximately at 20 degrees Celsius. Approximately, I'm saying. Okay. In fact, it is 330. I will just give you a small formula. Vt is Vo. This is a small formula. Vt means it's the temperature at which you want. Okay. V naught is the current temperature into 0.6. The 0.6 factor is important. Delta T. Delta T means what? It depends on the change in temperature. So when I say 330, this is at 0 degrees Celsius. So let us say 330. Okay. You want to find at 20 degrees Celsius. What should be the temperature at 20 degrees? So actually the answer is 342. 342 meter is 20. This is around 80. How to find it? Every degree rise in temperature, the speed increases by 0.6. So this is at 0 degree, 0.6. You wanted at 20. So put 20 here. So 330, when you multiply this, you will get 12. So 342 meter per second. Clear? So you can just make a note of this formula. When speed of sound is, let us say, 330 and light is 3 into 10 raised to 8 meter per second, you need to by heart this value. So there is a thundering occurring and as well as lightning. Out of these two, what will you experience first, thundering or lightning? Answer is lightning. Why? Because light travels faster than sound. And you have to mention the speed. Speed is 330 meter per second. And here, the speed is 3 into 10 raised to 8. It is huge. So, you will experience lightning first. Let us take few examples, numericals. The distance between the source of sound and observer is 1650 meters. Time taken to reach this is 5 seconds. Find speed of sound. Now you know that speed formula is distance upon time. Distance is 1650. Time is 5. So when you divide this, you will get 3 is 0 meter per second. Okay. Sometimes they will say the distance between consecutive compression or consecutive rarefaction is 20 meter. Time taken, the time period is say 0.5. Find the speed. So consecutive compression or consecutive rarefaction means this. This is 20 meter. Time period is 0.5 second. You have been asked to find B. You know what this, what do we call 20 meter? This is nothing but lambda. That is frequency. And this is the time period. You know that B is lambda F. I have written it over here. Now they are not talking about F. So lambda into 1 by T. Lambda is 20. 1 by T is 1 by 0.5. When you divide this, you will get 40. But it is speed. So meter per second. 40 meter per second is the answer. Okay. So there are a few questions in exercise. The speed of light in air, speed of sound in air is 330 meter per second. And speed of sound in iron, say it is 1500 meter per second. The distance traveled, by sound in air and as well as in iron, say it is 3.3 kilometers. Find time taken in air, time taken in iron. That is the question. I repeat, speed of sound in air is 330 meter per second and in iron is 1500 meter per second. Distance to be covered is 3.3 kilometer. Find the time taken. So what you will do, you will make two columns. Time formula is distance by speed. Distance is in kilometer. You will convert to meter. You will multiply by 1000. So it will be 3300 upon time. Upon speed. Speed is 330. 00 cut. Answer will be 10 seconds. So it will take 10 seconds in air. And here it is 3300 upon 1500. 00 cut. 00 cut. Now you will divide. This will go in 3 cut table. So 11 by 5. Okay. And then you will find this will be 2.2 seconds. So you can see the time taken in sound is low. Or you can see the sound travel faster in solid, then in liquid, then in gas. Why? Because the particles are very close to each other. So sound travel fastest in solid, then liquid, then in gas. So numericals are very easy in this chapter. In the last part of the chapter, this you have already studied. We have three types of sounds. One is infrasonic. The frequency is less than 20 hertz. It is heard by elephants, rhinoceros. Then we have audible range, which human beings can hear. 20 to 20,000 and then is ultrasonic or also called as ultrasound. Definition, frequency is greater than 20,000 hertz. This is example is rhinoceros, elephant, humans, even animals, your bats, dolphins, cats and so on. Now ultrasonic definition, it is a sound having frequency greater than 20,000 hertz. What is the speciality? What are the properties? It is highly energetic. It has high penetrating power. Penetrating power means what? It can go inside anything. And it has high directivity. What is the meaning of directivity? Means wherever you point it, it will go there only. It will not go here and there. These are the properties. Please do not write properties like it has frequency more than 20,000 hertz. No, that is the definition. Properties means the characteristic. It is very energetic, high penetrating power. It can enter our body also. And directivity means wherever you direct, it will go there only. So what are the applications of ultrasound. Ultrasound, it is used by bats to catch the prey or food. It is used in sonography. Sonography for finding the kidney stone. Also, pregnant women go for sonography. So these are all are the applications. It is also used by for ECG. ECG means what? ECG, have you seen this? Heartbeats? Yes, ECG. That is echocardiogram. It is also used, the ultrasound is high penetrating power. So the machine will generate that. It is also used to cut cataract during cataract operation. Cataract is nothing but in Hindi we call it as moti bindu or motiya ya moti. To cut that also we use ultrasound. It is used by sonar. What is sonar? We have studied already in 7th and 8th. Sonar is sound navigation and ranging. Sonar is used by the ship to find the depth of the sea. It's also used in many industries for cutting hard object. That also it is used. So you can give 3-4 examples of ultrasound. It is used by bats, cats, rats, ECG to remove cataract. Then sonography or ultrasound. Sonar, full form is sound navigation and ranging. Okay, the last part of the chapter is supersonic sound. What is the meaning of supersonic? Super is great, sonic. Any sound, any vehicle which is having speed greater than speed of sound. Supersonic, super means better. Any body which is going with a speed greater than speed of sound. Example, speed of sound is 330 meter per second. We have jet planes, fighter planes. We have Formula One race, bullet trains. The speed of all these vehicles will be greater than 330 meter per second. So we say the speed is supersonic speed. Whenever they pass, even if they have gone, you can still hear them. You have that sensation. This is because they are supersonic. Clear? So we end the chapter.